Howdy, folks. Welcome to the Wild West Crypto Show Daily Update, brought to you by Carnomaly. Once again, IEO is on Tuesday. It's on several exchanges. Get in, create an account, and get in early, folks. This is going to be a good one. Speaking of a good one.
Well, I'll tell you what. I don't know how good it is. You know, it reminds me of that old Anita Baker song, where reality is coming into view, no longer living lives in paradise. So anyway, markets are down. We're down 35.98 on Bitcoin. And let's go and look at that chart. And if you look at that, this is a chart going back to December, beginning of December. So for 3 months, you can see we had a wild ride and we're giving some of it back. And I told you we were going to.
Yeah.
And it's not unusual to give back 60% of the move. So if we go from 20 to 40, 60% of that 20% is 12%. So, you know, we could get down to 28 and not really be out of line with anything. So, yeah, I've got to just kind of keep that in mind. Overall market's down almost 10%, just like Bitcoin. Dow's off 0.04%, down 12. S&P's up 1.22. NASDAQ's up 108. Gold is at 252 on the negative side. And let's go look at a chart of that. That's what it's been doing since the beginning of December. And so you can see that it's had a lot of movement, but we haven't created a whole lot of light.
Yeah.
We've created a lot of heat. And same thing with silver. And then let's go look at crude. And look at how crude is just chug, 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 chug. And ever since we had the big drop that came down back in November time period, you know, it's just kind of been the little engine that can, and it keeps coming up. So much for all the wind and solar that's going to get rid of fossil fuels. Then let's look at the December 21. It's at 34.8. We're at 31.8. That's a $3,000 delta there between the two. And so they're still looking for Bitcoin to be higher. But I think what's going to have to happen is we're going to have to start digesting some of the news of what these people think they're going to make everybody do.
Yeah, the new economy, the Biden.
The new economy.
Hey, Biden, you got it, buddy. It's yours. The new Biden economy.
Now, you know, wasn't there like 10,000 people died of COVID yesterday?
Oh, yeah. Well, he was being
so you've killed 10,000 people.
Yeah, already.
Already, man.
First day in office. Speaking of that.
Most deadliest first day in office in history.
Yeah, exactly. Biden, where are you at on that one, buddy? Let's talk in a little departure here, but I thought it was kind of interesting. Biden gets inaugurated. He's nominated Janet Yellen, be Treasury, who did a poor job in her first go around.
Right.
So he's going to bring her back, and that's what he's doing with kind of most of them. There's no originality with that guy. So he's going to bring her back, and cryptos fall. So,
Well, wonder why.
Yeah, she's anti-crypto. That's the first thing she said.
But the good thing is she's going to kill the dollar worse than she's going to kill crypto.
That's true. So you're still better off.
All my crypto friends out there, buck up.
Yeah.
Okay? I mean, you're going to have a little wild ride. But the reality is she's going to kill International Monetary Fund, fiat. She's going to kill all of that stuff long before she gets crypto debt.
Yeah, they're trying to pass that. They're trying to pass that new bill that gives China $2 trillion to do whatever they want and turn people. Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah. The only safe haven's going to be. And speaking of that, it's kind of funny to go and say, you know, we talked about Jamie Dimon with J.P. Morgan Chase years ago saying, don't get into cryptos, and then you read down it, and they were actually getting into them themselves. Analysts at J.P. Morgan have come out saying that Bitcoin's value proposition as a competitor to gold is not a reliable hedge, okay? Now, what's really funny about that is that as you go down and you read the article, it's the same typical deal, that as part of the report, JP Morgan analysts maintained that Bitcoin had a low correlation with hedges over the last 5 years. Well, gold, traditionally ascribed to the hedge asset status, is up 70% over the last 5 years, and Bitcoin is up 7,000%. Where's that towel? Throw it down.
Yeah.
7,000% over the last 5 years. And why is JP Morgan doing that? They haven't figured out a way to get y'all to, they can make all the money they want to off of it. And until they do, stay away from it. It's not a good move. I just thought that was kind of
hilarious. Well, and the thing you got to do is you got to kind of understand what they mean by term of a hedge, okay? And a hedge is basically an investment that protects from some other investment doing something wrong.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
And so there's some things that you get utilities if you want to be against the cyclicals, and you know do raw materials if you want to be against this, that, and the other thing, and they provide hedges. You know, Bitcoin's not intended as a hedge.
Yeah.
Although it works pretty well.
Yeah, well, obviously. People that are in it, ask them where they'd rather had their money allocated. And so, J.P. Morgan, you may be big boys, but don't mean you ain't stupid. I have to tell you, and you know, Brent, we may ought to start doing a separate little deal that we do on and maybe just a weekly basis, or whatever. The Dismantling of America by Joe Biden.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because we could track it on a weekly basis, and that would just remind those people every week that voted for him. You know, now maybe we put on the dark suits and the veils. You know, as America. But listen to this:
we do the New Orleans style funeral.
Yes, exactly, exactly. So let me tell you something. Executive overreach day one of the Biden administration. I just thought the construction on the border wall was halted immediately. However, the construction of the fence around our nation's capital is intact, and they're saying it may be there to stay. Now, that's an interesting thing to me. Back in the old days of the White House and all that, Grover Cleveland used to sit on the front of that thing smoking a cigar and greet anybody that came up. And more and more, they're having to fortify our government offices, and yet they don't want to fortify the borders to this country. And anyway, doesn't make sense to me, and we're out of time. None of it makes sense to me. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you back here again tomorrow.